Well, hello everyone. It's great to be with you this Wednesday after Easter. And this week is also referred to as Easter Octave, or 8 days of Eastertide. And, you know, we're so happy to be celebrating the resurrection of our Lord. So I think before we start praying, I think we'll just listen to a hymn. And we've heard it before, but I think it's really special today. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. And it's Hosanna in the highest. Of course, we sang that hymn on Palm Sunday, but I think it's still relevant on Easter Sunday, Easter, the octave of Easter, that you know, we're paying praise to the Lord. He is risen. So the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with each and every one of you. And we haven't done this in quite a while, but part of our video, or part of our reaction to offering up our wrongdoings is a prayer that many of us know. And so let us acknowledge our sins and prepare ourselves to celebrate these special mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words and what I have done, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Amen. Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy. Christ have mercy. Christ have mercy. Lord have mercy. And as we begin, I'm just going to pull up this little image, and I think it's kind of Father Justin DeRush sent it out to a number of us, and I thought it was kind of sweet. I hope you can see it. But I'll read it to you. What did the dessert say to the mashed potatoes? Leave space for me. Yes, we were often told to leave enough space for dessert. The dessert will never take the place of the potatoes, but the dessert is asking for the opportunity to take its place. Nor is the dessert asking to take off the space, but it is seeking its own place. Because of its own taste, Easter is that special moment when God is seeking his place in our lives, not to take all the space, but to be recognized as a gift to humanity. Easter celebration, you need to leave space for the suffering phase. Let it not take the whole space. Leave space for the rest, because it is the best. And so that's also a tradition in our church now that we're into the Easter season, is when, you know, before we do the readings, we hear the hymn, Glory to God. It's just a short hymn. Well, yes, glory to God in the highest. And as I mentioned, this week now after Sunday, we're into the octave of Easter, which is also called, as I mentioned, Eastertide. And each day is very important. Each day is a solemnity in the church calendar. And back in early days, I mean, I can even remember them. Each day we would be celebrating. And our readings reflect that. Our readings now, our first readings are from, of course, the New Testament, usually Acts from St. Paul. And each reading is about how Jesus visits the disciples or the women, during his before his resurrection. And often they don't recognize him at the beginning, and it is not till after he leaves that they realize that he was there. And we end up this coming Sunday with Divine Mercy Sunday, and that ends the octave of Easter. But we do have so much to be thankful for. And in today's psalm, the earth is full of the goodness of the Lord. This is not about the way we humans make plans for our lives and work. Rather, it is a much bigger view of who we are and what we are. It is God's plan and His will for us. We need to hunger more each day for Him, for God is our help, our shield, and most importantly, He gives us that eternal hope, that we all long for. And what's really important in the four Gospels, Mary Magdalene, and I always say to women, never feel that you're not important in our church, because you are. It was the women that Jesus first appeared to. It was Mary Magdalene, the first woman to discover the empty tomb. And of course, Mary didn't recognize Jesus because her focus was not on Jesus, but the empty tomb. And often that happens in our own lives. He's right in front of us, and we just don't recognize him. And it wasn't until he called her name that Mary then recognized Jesus. And of course, when she told the disciples, "I have seen the Lord," there was a little bit of doubt. But this is very essential to part of our Christianity. So the resurrection of Jesus is the foundation of our hope, and this hope allows us to see God's way and God's plan. Jesus said, "Stop holding on to me. I'm going to be my Father. I'm going to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God. Do you believe that He will always be there for you?" And I think that's our challenge in life. And the other important part of the resurrection of the Lord, the crucifixion of our Lord and the resurrection, is this gives us the opportunity that when we end our earthly life, we have that opportunity to be risen, just as our Lord was risen, to spend time in eternity. And it's really hard to conceive, that we have that opportunity. And it really boils down to how we live our life. So let's just keep our hearts open this week to the love Jesus has for us, and more important, the love that his Father, the love that Jesus' Father had for his Son that he gave to us through the resurrection of our Lord. So let's have another hymn, and of course, crown him with many crowns.
Awake, my soul.
That's a nice hymn, too. So as we continue in prayer, and during this Easter octave, we're so appreciative of the small little miracles that happen in our lives. Let us continue to pray. Weather's nice, and hopefully many of you will be able to get outside and spend some time in this nice weather. And what's the saying? April showers, spring May flowers. And so let us pray. Let us pray for those who we love that we can't be with, and we are thinking of them every day. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. And let us pray for more people to get vaccinated. There's many people doubtful about the vaccine, but it's so important that people get vaccinated. And so let us pray for all those who have doubt. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. And of course, we need to pray for all those people, the frontline workers that, hopefully they will get vaccinated, but we just need that to happen quicker, sooner than later. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. And of course, we need to pray for our sick people. You know, there's a number of people in our parish, in our community, that are struggling, some with COVID, but more just with life and life issues. And we need to pray for them. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. And of course, most important too, we pray for those who have died. That their memories and their lives are continue to dwell in our hearts and our souls, and that's a blessing back to them. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. As we say the prayer that our Father's given us, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. And Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. And although, you know, we can't receive communion in our traditional way, and now that our churches are in this new lockdown, our numbers are restricted. They're open, but restricted numbers. So, and of course, this is a sacramental blessing. My Jesus, we believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. We love you above all things, and we desire you in our soul. Since we cannot receive you sacramentally, we do ask that you come spiritually into our hearts, as we know that you are always there for us. We embrace you, we unite ourselves wholly to you, and permit not that we should ever be separated from you. Amen. And, as we go throughout this week, just keep in mind the joyous celebration that we are celebrating, especially this week, you know, the resurrection of our Lord, and, how our Lord continues to visit, the disciples and many individuals to just prove that he is the risen Lord. And I've got a neat little hymn. I thought this would, hopefully it will cheer everybody up. And it's an Irish hymn, but it's Lord of the Dance.
In the morning when the world was begun, and I danced in the moon, the stars and the sun. I came near from heaven and I danced on the earth. At Bethlehem I had my birth. Dance then, wherever you may be, I am the Lord of the dance, said he. I'll lead you all, wherever you may be, and I'll lead you all in the dance, said he. I danced for the scribe and the Pharisee, but they would not dance and they wouldn't follow me. I danced for the fishermen, James and John. They came with me and the dance went on. Dance there, wherever you may be. I am the Lord of the Dance, said he. I'll lead you all, wherever you may be, and I'll lead you all in the dance, said he. I danced on the Sabbath and I cured the lame. The holy people said it was a shame. They whipped and they stripped and they hung me in high and left me there on a cross to die. Dance then, wherever you may be. I am the Lord of the dance, said he. I'll lead you all, wherever you may be, and I'll lead you all in the dance, said he. I danced on a Friday when the sky turned black. It's hard to dance with the devil on your back. They buried my body and they thought I'd gone, but I am the dance and I still go on. Dance then, whatever you may be. I am the Lord of the dance, said he. I'll lead you all, whatever you may be, and I'll lead you all in the dance, said he. They cut me down and I left up high. I am the life that will never, never die. I'll live in you if you live in me. I am the Lord of the dance, said he. Dance then, whatever you may be. I am the Lord of the dance, said he. And I'll lead you all, whatever you may be. And I'll lead you all in the dance, said he. Dance then, whatever you may be. I am the Lord of the dance, said he. And I'll lead you all, whatever you may be. And I'll lead you all in the dance, said he.
Isn't that nice? I really enjoyed that when I heard that. So as we continue our final blessing, let us bow our heads for God's blessing this Easter season. May God, who by the resurrection of his only begotten Son, was pleased to confer on you the gifts of redemption and of adoption, give you gladness by his blessings. Amen. May he, by whose redeeming work you have received the gift of everlasting freedom, may you heir to an eternal inheritance. Amen. And may you, who have already risen with Christ in baptism through faith, by living in the right manner on earth, be united with him in the homeland of heaven. Amen. And the Lord be with us and with your spirit. And may the Lord's blessing of the Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. And go in peace, my friends. It's so good to be with you every week. I really enjoy this, and I can't wait till I can be there in person. So I'll just conclude with another hymn, and where I had it here already for us. He's got the whole world in his hand. Bye for now. God bless. Peace be with you.
He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got everybody here in his hands. He's got everybody here in his hands. He's got everybody here in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the little